Today we will be showing you how to replace a Tandberg LTO half-height SCSI interface tape drive. It will cover procedures for both tabletop units and internally mounted drives inside server or rack mount enclosures. Due to the nature of SCSI connected devices, when replacing them, we always recommend scheduling downtime and powering off the host that they are connected to. This will prevent any host communication issues, as the drive will be negotiated with the host during the server post process. Once you have scheduled downtime, before powering off your host machine, you should always check to see if there is a tape inside the faulty tape drive. If there is, please attempt to use the eject button on the front of the tape drive to eject the tape. If it fails to eject properly and the tape is stuck, you will need to manually remove your tape from the drive once you have completed the replacement. Please see our video about removing a stuck tape from a Tandberg LTO tape drive if you have any questions on how this process works. Once you have verified that the drive is clear of any tapes and powered off your host machine, it will now be time to power off your tape drive if it is a tabletop unit or rack mount enclosure. If it is an internal drive inside the server, it will have powered off when you shut down the host server. To power off a tabletop unit or rack mount enclosure, hit the power button on the unit once. Now, if this is a tabletop unit, the next step will be to unplug the power cable from the back of the unit and then remove the SCSI cable and terminator. If this is an internal drive inside a server or rack mount enclosure, you will need to first gain access to the internal area of the server or rack mount enclosure and then unplug the SCSI and power cables from the rear of the drive. If this is an internal drive, you will now need to unmount it from the server or rack mount enclosure. Please follow the correct procedure for your specific application to do this. As there are many different applications for these style drives, we cannot cover them all in this video. Any specific questions should be directed to your server or rack mount enclosure OEM or maintenance provider. Once you have the drive ready for replacement, the last thing that needs to be done is to verify the SCSI ID of the faulty drive. For tabletop units, this will be in the form of a SCSI ID panel on the rear of the drive. It will have a number displayed along with up and down buttons that allow you to change the SCSI ID. You will need to verify that the replacement drive is set to the same SCSI ID as the faulty drive before hooking the replacement drive to the host system. If this is an internal drive, the SCSI ID is set in the form of the SCSI ID block. For any replacement drive, you will want to match the SCSI ID block jumpers to the same as the faulty drive had been. If your replacement drive did not come with any jumpers installed, you will need to move them over from the faulty drive to the replacement. If this is a new install, please consult the OEM of your specific application for the correct SCSI ID block jumper settings that are needed. Once the SCSI ID is set properly on the replacement drive, it is now time to install and hook it up to your host system. For internal drives, please follow the appropriate procedure for your application to install the drive correctly into the server or rack mount enclosure. Then hook the SCSI and power cables to the rear of the drive and ensure they are secure before closing up the enclosure or server. For tabletop drives, please ensure that both the SCSI cable and terminator are hooked to the back of the unit correctly and are secured before plugging the power cable into the back of the unit. Now you can power on the drive if it is a tabletop unit or rack mount enclosure. Please wait for the drive to initialize completely and have a solid green status light. Now you can power on your host system. If you have the ability to do so, you should watch the post process of your host system and ensure that the drive is seen correctly on the host bus prior to booting into the operating system. If you do not see the drive displayed correctly during the post process of your host system, or in the operating system once it has been installed, please power the host system down and check all cabling going to the drive and ensure the SCSI ID is set correctly. Then power the host system back up. You will now need to reconfigure your backup software to be able to use the drive you just replaced. All backup software handles this process differently. For our purposes, since we use Symantec Backup Exec, we simply need to restart the services to allow the tape services to detect the replaced drive. Your backup software procedure may be different. Any questions regarding backup software should be directed to the manufacturer or software support. If you are having any issues with the replacement drive being seen by the host system, or the drive is not powering on correctly, please open a ticket through the Rocket Plus customer portal. Thanks for watching. This has been another video by the Top 10 USA Video Production Team. We look forward to sharing more content with you going forward, so please check out our YouTube channel and please subscribe so that you get notified whenever we release a new piece of content.